Good morning, boys and girls. I hope you're staying safe from all those fires out there. Well, let's see. Today's lesson, we are challenged to be ready to act in ways that show our faith in God. You know, and sometimes that is not easy, and sometimes we're a little afraid. God created us to do good works. He created us to spread the good news of who Jesus is and to tell people about the sacrifice that Jesus made for us so that we could be part of his family. Sometimes telling people about Jesus can be a little scary, or maybe we just don't have the confidence. But God wants to give us that confidence, and he wants us to step out in faith and trust him that he's going to give us the words to speak. In our lesson today, we're going to learn about a woman who risked her life for the people of Israel. Her name is Esther. She was made queen. And you can find her story in the Old Testament in the book called Esther. Her actions of bravery saved the Jewish people and protected the family line through which Jesus would be sent into this world. Now that was a very, very big thing that she did. Now this same great God who cares for the Jewish people loves and cares for you too. And he offers you salvation. So let's see how Esther showed her bravery and how God used her story to keep the Jewish people safe.
Well, I think all of you have gone back to school by now. I know my grandsons just started this week, and so I was helping them get together the things that they would need to go back to school. You know, we want to be prepared for whatever God has for us. So I got a backpack and got them some new notebooks and got this fun pack of pencils. Did you guys get some new pencils this year? And some pens. And you know what? They always tell you you need a ruler. And then how about some new scissors? Just, you know, the safety kind with the round tips, because my grandkids are kind of young still. And I said, well, for sure you need glue. But sometimes it's better to have glue stick. I like to have both of them because you never know what you're gonna make or have to cut out. And you know what's kind of fun is to have a hole punch, because sometimes you have to, you know, instead of cutting, you could just use this and make the circles, or, you know, put holes in, and a little stapler just in case. You never know how a staple remover, if you staple something together that shouldn't have been stapled. Anyway, those are some of the things I got together and put in a backpack for my kids, but, you know, wanting them to be ready. And I think we all want to be ready for what God has for us. So in today's story, there's someone who God prepared, and she was ready when it was time for God to use her. The story I was talking about is the story of Esther. Esther is found in our Old Testament about halfway through, right after the book of Nehemiah. Last week, our story was about Nehemiah who built the wall. This week, the story of Esther. And the whole story is about, the whole book is about her story. So she must have been pretty important, and what she did was very important for the Jewish people. So let me introduce you to some of our characters in today's story. This here is the king, and his name in some Bibles is very long. It's Ahasuerus, but other translations of the Bible just call him King Xerxes. So we'll call him Xerxes today. Then we have his wife. He was married, and her name was Vashti. And she was a very beautiful woman. We'll talk about her in a minute. And then there was a very humble man who was Jewish. His name was Mordecai. And he lived in the kingdom where King Xerxes was. And then there was a beautiful orphan girl whose name was Hadassah. But the Bible said that her other name was Esther. And Esther means star, because she was brilliant and radiant and showed the love of God. Well, there's somebody else, but we'll wait to introduce him later. So let's begin our story. Most of our story takes place in the palace. Well, the palace where our story takes place was in the land of Persia, in a place called Susa, and that's where King Xerxes reigned. And they said he was a very well-liked king, and he loved to give parties. The Bible tells us that he had a party that lasted 180 days, and he invited all his friends and all the wealthy people, as well as the villagers, to come and celebrate with him. Well, at this one party, he wanted to have his wife come in so he could show off her beauty, because she was indeed very beautiful, Vashti. And he was going to call her, but she refused to come. So this made the king very angry. And he said, what am I going to do? So he called in his counselors and said, what should be done? And they said, well, she should never come before your presence again. But they had an idea that they needed to find the king a new queen. So they gathered up and went out into the villages and the surrounding areas of Susa and gathered in all the young women. And among them was Esther. So Esther was summoned to the palace, and that was a little scary. She didn't know what's going to happen there, but maybe she would become one of the servant girls or something else and something better. But before she went, her uncle Mordecai told her, oh, do not let them know that you are Jewish. Do not let them know you're a Jew. So when she went to the palace, she remembered those words and didn't tell anybody. But while she was there, this is what happened. They had all these young girls, and they would prepare them to go before the king. But it took a whole year of beauty treatments. So they would go, and they said for 6 months, they would have oils just sprayed on them to make their skin so nice and soft. And then they would get beauty treatments. They learned how to put on their makeup so that they could look their best when it was their turn to go before the king. I can't imagine a whole year of just learning how to be beautiful. You know, me, I'm like 5 minutes and I'm done. I'm ready for the date. That's it. So Esther was then, after a year, called before the king. And when King Xerxes saw her, he loved her. And he said, I am going to make you my queen. So she became the queen of Persia. Meanwhile, King Xerxes had appointed a man named Haman to be one of the leaders in his land. But Haman was not a good man. He was very evil and very prideful man. They said he was full of pride and thought very highly of himself. Now, if you were to be a leader, what would you want to do to the people, for the people? Wouldn't you want to go out and help them and make sure that they had their needs supplied and take care of them? Well, this man, all he could think about was that he wanted the people to bow down before him. So when he went out in the city places in front of the palace, he required that people would bow down to him and bow as he went by. Well, there was someone who would not do that, and that was Mordecai, Esther's uncle. He did not bow to anyone but to the living God. And this made Haman very angry. So Haman devised a plot that he would kill not just Mordecai, but all the Jews in the land. And he sent out a decree, and they had it posted on all the buildings and all around that all the people could see. It said, hear ye, on the 13th day of the 12th month, all Jewish people in all 127 provinces of Persia are to be killed, including the women and children, by order of the king. Well, the king really hadn't ordered it, but because he was one of the leaders, he used the king's signet ring, and he was able to stamp the king's name on this law. Well, when Mordecai saw that law, and the people, they were so afraid, and they were so worried and upset, thinking they were all going to be killed. So he went to Esther. Or he sent someone to Esther, sent a message and said, Esther, you have to help us. You're in the palace. Go before the king and appeal for your people. And he said, you know, maybe the Bible says that God has put you in the palace for such a time as this. But what Esther knew was that she couldn't go before the king, because only if you were summoned to the king. She was only allowed to go before the king. And she told her uncle, only if you get everybody to pray and fast with me for 3 days, then I will go before the king, because he will need to extend his royal scepter. If I go before him, I could be killed. So they said, Mordecai went, and all the people prayed and fasted. That means they went without food for 3 days. And then Esther went before the king. And as she entered the throne room, He saw her, and remember, he loved her. So he extended his scepter and said, come in. And she said, oh, my king. He goes, Esther, what do you want? Anything you want, up to half my kingdom. And she said, well, I'd like you to come for dinner tonight on my side of the palace and bring Haman with you. And so they went, and the king and Haman went to the palace, and he said, well, what can I give you? She goes, oh, that night, she said, could you come back tomorrow for another dinner? And at this point, Haman, he must have been so proud, going, I'm something special. She wants me to come back again. He thought he was really, you know, great. But when they came back the second day, the plan was that Esther was going to reveal the plot that Haman had devised. And when they came to dinner that night, she did. And the king did not know until that point that Esther was a Jew. And with his proclamation, he was saying he intended to kill Queen Esther. And at that point, made King Xerxes furious. So he had Haman removed from his presence, and he had Haman killed out on the gallows, which was the hangman's thing that he had built, that Haman built to kill Mordecai. He got killed on his own gallows. So Haman annihilated, the King Xerxes. Instead of the Jews being annihilated, he killed Haman. But they could not, because a law is a law. They knew that there was nothing he could do. So the king gave Mordecai and Esther the permission to write a new law. And the new law said, well, when they come to kill the Jews, that the Jews could defend themselves. Because before that, they weren't even going to be able to. And the Bible says that they defended themselves, and not a single Jew was killed. Because of that, there was a holiday proclaimed, and all the people celebrated, and it is called Purim, which is celebrated to today. The Jews still celebrate Purim, which is the remembrance of when Esther saved all her people from Haman's evil plots. Thank you, Lord, that Esther was brave and that she was prepared and that she was there to do what God had called her to do. Let's pray that we will also be prepared to do what God calls us to do. Lord, I thank you for each child, and that you have given us plans and purposes, and you're preparing us for things in our life. Lord, may we be ready as Esther was to rise up and do what you call us to do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Well, hi everybody, I'm here with Granny today. Boy, Granny, I haven't seen you in a while.
Yes, I came by just to share a little story with you. Charlie came by and he mowed my grass this week, the front yard and the backyard.
Oh, wow, that's really nice of Charlie. What got into him?
Oh, he said he remembered the Bible verse. We are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works. Ephesians 2:10.
Oh, that's a great Bible verse. Yes, I know that one well. Gee, I need to do something nice this week, too, to show my good works.
I'm going to do the same thing for Charlie. I'm going to bake him some cookies, a whole batch of them. That will be my good works.
Oh, yes, it will. You know what? How about if you bake a couple extra for somebody you know named Chris?
Oh, I would love that. One or two for you? Would that be okay?
That would be perfect for me. Or three or four or five. Thanks, Granny.
You're welcome. Bye, everybody. Don't forget, we are God's workmanship created in Christ Jesus to do good works.
That's right. That's Ephesians 2:10. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Hey, so
I get to do the craft with you today. And what you're gonna need is your coloring sheet and some fine tipped markers or pencils. And you're gonna need scissors and tape. Yeah, it's pretty easy, but we're gonna make little finger puppets today. And our Bible verse is, we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works. It's Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. And Queen Esther knew that she was to do good work. And Mordecai knew that he was to do good work for God. And even though our story is in the Old Testament, our Bible verse comes from the New Testament, because God knew us all before we were ever born. He knew everybody that lived in the Old Testament, everybody that lived in the New Testament, and everybody that's ever gonna live. And we are God's workmanship. Boys and girls, you can see that I've already started to cut out my characters, and I'm gonna just cut along the dark line to divide Haman from Mordecai, from Queen Esther, and King Xerxes. And you can see that I've continued on with my coloring. So I didn't cut in yet. I haven't cut the line here because eventually these are going to be finger puppets, and you'll need to wait after you've colored, and then we're going to wrap them around our fingers. So I went on the internet to look to see what King Xerxes, what Queen Esther, and what Mordecai, and what Haman might be wearing. And I chose colors, like he's got some royal green, turquoise, red. I used the yellow, kind of look gold. I even colored the emblems for King Xerxes, his royal emblem. And I picked these colors for Queen Esther. And so you boys and girls can choose what you want to do. And then I decided to color this portion down here that's going to wrap around my fingers. So boys and girls, I'm going to let you go ahead and cut out each character. And while it's still in a square, you're going to color so that they look. I'm going to cut this one so that they look like they belong to royalty, as they each did. Then once you have them colored, you can see that I cut out just slightly around the whole character. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. So I'm gonna cut in on this bold line and stop where the bold line stops. And then I'm gonna cut up and around. And I'm going up and around and leaving a little bit over the top. Oh, that's about a half an inch. And I'm going all the way around Mordecai. And there we go. I have Mordecai cut out. And I'm gonna do the same thing for Haman. I'm gonna cut in on the dark lines, but not beyond the dark line. And in here. And then I'm going to come up without cutting off his hand. And I'm going to come up and around about a half an inch above his hat or turban. And around. Terrific. Did it. And now I have each one of my
Bible story characters. I have Mordecai, and it already says Mordecai on it. And I have Queen Esther, and I have King Xerxes, and I have Haman. Now let's make them puppets. I'm getting ready to make our finger puppets. I should have said finger puppets before, but I'm gonna need a piece of tape. So I'm getting my tape ready, and I'm making my tape about an inch long, and I'm preparing it right here so that when I go to wrap my finger puppets around my finger, my tape will be ready. But you know what? I like that Mordecai is identified. So I'm gonna go ahead and write Queen Esther. Do you know how to write the word queen? Q-U-E-E-N Esther. E-S-T-H-E-R. And Xerxes, king. Do you know how to spell king? K-I-N-G. And Xerxes, what a fun name. X-E-R-X-C-E-S. And Haman. Haman's the bad guy in our story. H-A-M-A-N. Great. Now I'm ready to make them finger puppets. So I'm going to start with Queen Esther. And boys and girls, what you're going to need to do is you're going to take your first finger and you're going to put it right in the middle, up the back. And you're going to hold it with your thumb. So your finger's up the middle in the back. And you're going to wrap. Now, if this is too long, you can cut a little off the edge. My fingers are a little bit bigger than yours are. So I'm going to wrap Queen. I'm going to go around this way. It's okay if we cover up Queen Esther a little bit. And I'm going to wrap it around like this. But now I need that piece of tape, right? So I'm holding it with my finger. I'm going to grab this piece of tape. And I'm going to tape it like that. And then, oops, I made that piece of tape too long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tuck it in. Stay. I'll tuck that down there. Great. And now I have my first finger puppet, Queen Esther. And I'm going to do it again. Will she stand up? Stay, Queen Esther. And I'm going to do the same thing. Let's do Mordecai next. Mordecai, her cousin that raised her up to be a queen. And I'm going to wrap it around this way and wrap it around like this and hold it with my middle finger like that. I'm going to take one of my pieces of tape and tape my finger puppet. Is this going to work? Oh, come on. Sometimes it gets tricky. I have to try it again and see what happens. You might have to ask somebody to help you. All right, I did it. And then like that. And I have Mordecai. Very good. Mordecai, can you hang out there? You might have to lay down like that. And I'm going to do the same thing with King Xerxes. Let's see if I can do it faster. Okay, see, that's a problem if that comes all the way around the sides. So let me go this way. Put that in, put that on that side. More than one way, skin a cat. Tape on. Did that work? Didn't cover up. Did it cover it up? It's all right. King Xerxes. That's okay. Right? Oh, bump, bump. And amen. Let's see if I can do it one more time. All right. That way. That one's too long. Go that way. Go that way. I should have cut them off a little bit. There's my tape. Tape it on there. Did it work? Good. And ta-da! Now I have my Queen Esther. And I have her cousin Mordecai that raised her up to be a lovely woman worthy of being a queen. Thank you, cousin Mordecai, for raising me up to be worthy to be a queen. And he said, okay, go present yourself to King Xerxes. And I thought, King Xerxes? Oh, King Xerxes thinks that Queen Esther is beautiful and wants to make her his queen. And Mordecai said, but don't tell anybody that you're a Jew, because we don't want anybody to think you're not worthy of being a queen. And then we've got Haman. And Haman was plotting to kill King Xerxes. And Mordecai knew it. And also, Haman said, bow to me, you Jews, or I will kill you. And Mordecai asked Queen Esther to please go talk to King Xerxes and tell him what Haman had plotted. And Xerxes got so mad, he said, Haman, you are no longer the vizier or the ruler. I'm making Mordecai the new vizier of the land. And they lived happily ever after.
Thunder, thy power throughout. Queen Esther was brave. Even when she was in danger, she showed courage and acted to rescue God's people from death. God used Esther to keep the Jewish people safe. And then many years later, God sent Jesus to be born into a Jewish family. God loved and cared for the Jewish people. And God loves and cares for you, too. And He offers salvation through Jesus Christ.